Here we go! What's up guys, it's time to officially look beyond the Galaxy S22 series. I know it's only been 2 months, but the show must go on. Samsung, although they have done an amazing job with the Galaxy S22 series from design to cameras, but there's still some serious work that needs to be done with the S23 series next year. And yes, the S23 series is indeed coming because we now actually know the project code name for this next flagship lineup, which is said to be Diamond. There's always some hidden secret behind choosing a certain codename, so if we look at the previous years, some of these codenames make a lot of sense, like the Galaxy S8 with the Dream codename, which obviously indicates the big design change that we got. Beyond for the S10 series, which was probably the biggest leap in smartphone design at the time. Hubble for the Galaxy S20 series, which brought the periscope zoom on the scene. Taking this history into consideration, these codenames are definitely not as random as you think. So what could be the meaning behind Diamond? Well, this could indicate a massive design change. If you look at the Galaxy S22 Ultra, its front design is almost identical to the 2-year-old Galaxy Note 20 Ultra. It's still the best smartphone design right now, but will Samsung continue this design for the third time in 2023? That is a big question that can lead them to reinvent the look of the Galaxy S23 Ultra. If you notice the shape of a diamond, it has all sides curved. Does that mean we'll see a quad curve display on the S23 Ultra? There might be a little bit of possibility of that happening. Samsung already has multiple patents, and even from last year where we have seen a Galaxy phone with a super quad curve display, or as Samsung says, a surround display design. Again, this is all speculation. The only thing that we know right now is the project code name, which is Diamond. The other thing that is expected to happen is the under display camera. And to be honest, I don't really think that the under display cameras are as good as the current selfie sensors on smartphones, so this might not happen. Again, we still have like 9-10 months for the S23 series to come out, so Samsung might surprise us all. Now, the second leak we have regarding the S23 Ultra is with its camera upgrade. This news came out a couple of months ago. According to Exynos, Samsung could use a new 200 megapixel sensor on the S23 Ultra. They've already used the 108 megapixel sensor for 3 generations, so next year could be the true sensor upgrade. In case you haven't noticed, the S22 Ultra has the same sensor as the S21 Ultra, so it's very obvious that Samsung will try to bring a proper main camera sensor upgrade on the S23 Ultra. Now with this, I also expect Samsung to bump the ultra-wide-angle lens resolution as well to at least 50 megapixels, because Samsung has stayed with 12 megapixel ultra-wide-angle lens for years. I think it's definitely time for that upgrade. Now one thing that's almost guaranteed is that the 5G speeds will be even faster on the Galaxy S23 series. Yes, the Snapdragon X70 5G modem that will be inside 2023 Android flagships and even the iPhone 15 is already official. The S23 series could be one of the first, if not the first devices to ship with this next-gen beast chip. Now speaking of chips, this is one area where they absolutely have to improve. This year, we barely had any big improvements to the performance. Both Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 and Exynos 2200 are not at their best because of mediocre cooling solution. It's rumored that Qualcomm could develop its own custom ARM cores to have better performance, better heat management, and better efficiency. The Snapdragon 8 Gen 2 could bring some huge improvements to the table for the Galaxy S23 series. Now we have no idea what Samsung will do with its Exynos 2300. Despite having AMD in their team, they couldn't really deliver the top performance. Here's something crazy. For the first time ever, Samsung is expected to use a Mediatek chip on its Galaxy S flagship phone, which is going to be the S22 Fan Edition. If that actually happens and Samsung is able to get good results out of it, then having a Mediatek Dimensity 10,000 chip on the S23 series next year is not out of question. Again, we have no idea what Samsung will do with its Exynos chips next year, but Qualcomm, they're gonna take some really big steps. Now, last major breakthrough that we need that is obviously very dependent on the chips is the battery performance. The iPhone 13 Pro Max is still the king of battery performance. It actually beats the S22 Ultra by a very decisive margin. Samsung has to figure out the battery thing, because Apple, they're gonna step their game even more by switching to 3 nanometer architecture, so hopefully with Project Diamond, we could see some big breakthroughs with the battery performance. So there we go, that's all the latest news on the Galaxy S23 series. Let me know what you want to see on the Galaxy S23 series. Do you think there's going to be a big redesign of the display? Comment below. With that being said, I'll see you guys later. Peace out.